My first pro job is kind of arguable. I mean, I was an editor before I got any real writing work, so I guess that was a pro job, but I wanted to be a writer, so I think my first real, well, I did stuff for Wildstorm. I adapted Left Behind, which was like a fundamental religious apocalypse novel. But at the time, I was editing, and they said, "Make this book happen. You got to get someone to write a spec script." I knew no one would write a 45-page spec script. I also knew if I did it, and they approved it, I'd be the writer on it. So I did it, and I got paid a lot of money. 5 issues, prestige format, good rate, and royalties. And I was able to quit Wildstorm and live off that for a while. And I was also able to sort of leverage, because it was a really big deal, into a book called Bay City Jive, 3-issue miniseries Wildstorm did in 1991. And you know, it was basically a blowjob. I mean, it was. Wildstorm did me a favor because I helped make this Left Behind book happen. So they approved my dumb little Shaft meets Big Trouble in Little China book, which I am terribly proud of. Sold actually well by today's standards. You know, sold okay by their standards. It was never collected, and I did a lot of dumb things, like give Wildstorm the rights, and really I learned from it. I mean, everything I've done, I've learned a little from. I remember the first time I was getting my name in comics. First time I was working with Jonathan Peterson. I was his assistant editor, and he was actually helping Brandon Choi script a Heroes Reborn Fantastic Four. And they were working on a line, and they're like, "Oh, would Reed Richards say this or would he say that?" And I piped in, and I'm like, "Oh, what if you have him say that?" And they're like, "Oh, that's good. I'll use that line." And like, you know, to put your words into Reed Richards' mouth was pretty amazing. And even, you know, 16 years later, you're writing an issue of Spider-Man. There's something really cool about touching something like that that's been so beloved and by so many people, and it has such history in comics. It's really cool. I mean, the thrill isn't what it was 16 years ago, but the thrill never goes away, and hopefully it never will.